What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin Stelzer from Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about stapling Romex neatly. All right, there's already a bunch of you that are offended. There's a bunch of people that are like, it doesn't matter if you staple your Romex neatly or not. You're going to be covering it up with sheetrock. It doesn't matter. Who gives a shit? Just move on about your day. I totally get it. I get it. But I believe in taking pride in what I do. And when you have the attention span, the attentiveness to your work, to sit and make everything look good, even though it's going to be covered up, the definition of integrity... The definition of integrity is doing the right thing, even when nobody's looking. So, I like to staple very, very neatly. I like to put things in a very precise order. That way, when an inspector comes in to look at the work, he's like, holy shit, this guy does clean work. Like, I don't have to worry because I can tell he really cares about what he's doing. That's kind of the school of thought. I like to have anybody that comes behind me look at my work and be able to tell that. Now, not in every situation. There's some situations where like time is of an essence and you don't have a choice and you just gotta go. But you can still try to make it look as neat as possible. I mean, like putting a whole bunch of wires right next to each other and stapling them, like there's obviously the holy shit, he didn't care at all, or there's the oh my god, that looks amazing, but there's a lot of gray area in there. There's like, oh, I could tell he was in a hurry, but damn, that looks really good for being in a hurry. If we go into the code, into Article 334, where it talks about non-metallic sheath cable, it actually says under securing and supporting, non-metallic sheath cable shall be supported and secured by staples, cable ties listed and identified for securement and support, or straps, hangers, or similar fittings designed to and installed as to not damage the cable at intervals exceeding 1.4 meters or 4.5 feet. And within 300 millimeters, 12 inches of every cable entry to an enclosure such as an outlet box, junction box, cabinet, fitting, or flat cable shall not be stapled on edge. So that tells us everything that we need to know about stapling and securing this NM wire, this non-metallic sheathed wire that we call Romex. It doesn't say that you can't stick like a certain number of these things under a staple. You know, like some staples are longer, some are bigger, some are wider, some have a little plastic insulation on them, some don't. There's no reason why you have to use one or the other. They're all listed for use. And it says in here, as long as it is a cable tie or some kind of means of securement that is listed for securement and support. That could be anything. Cable ties, that could be zip ties. Like, there's so many different things that you can do to secure Romex. There's not one way that you have to do it. The only thing that they care about is not stapling Romex on edge. These are flat cables, so you need to put the cables down flat on top of each other and staple on top of that. Now there's this whole debate on how many pieces of Romex you're supposed to put under one staple. Some staples have listing requirements that say that you can only put one, some say two, a lot of them don't say anything at all, but there's kind of this debate that happens in all of these forums and Facebook groups. How many can you put three pieces of Romex under a staple? If there's a listing requirement for it, then that's what you should follow. Really, the whole idea is not bundling, because some people will use like huge inch and a half inch staples and they'll put a whole bunch of pieces of Romex under one staple. And then they're bundling all of these conductors together, and bundling is a big issue. So if you're running a whole bunch of pieces of Romex together in a group more than 24 inches for like 50 feet, and you're just stapling all of them together, you actually have to derate those conductors just like you would in conduit. If you run a whole bunch of current carrying conductors in a conduit, you have to derate the ampacity of them because there's so many of them together that there's not enough space to dissipate any kind of heat. There's capacitive coupling and a lot of different things that happen inside of conduit. So I'm not going to get into all of that. I'm going to do an episode coming up about NM cable specifically and all of the different considerations and securing and strapping and all that stuff. We're going to go through code on it. So I'm not going to get into all that here. I just want to at least mention that there is the bundling issue. So when you are stapling and stapling neatly, and stapling multiple pieces of Romex together, just make sure that you're not overdoing it, that you're not running like a whole bunch of pieces of Romex together and like zip tying all of them over a really long distance, because then you're actually going against code. You're not actually, the prettiness of it doesn't matter because it's wrong. So don't get into that. I just like to take pride in my work. I like to do something, know that it's done well, walk away from it and look at it and be like, yo, that looks fucking great, and then walk away. Like, just knowing that, having the confidence that I did something really good, gives me pride, and it makes me feel like I'm not just going to a job every day. It's like, it makes me feel like I'm honing a skill. So the other thing I have to say about it is the word integrity, right? Integrity means doing the right thing when nobody's looking. And I think that caring about what you do and trying to do really good work, even though it's going to be covered up, even though nobody's going to see it, you're going to see it. And having that mental discipline inside of yourself to really care about what you do, to try to make everything you touch look good, everything you touch be high quality. I think that's just it's a choice. It's right. It's an opinion. So like, who the fuck am I? Right? Whatever. Do whatever you're going to do. But that's just my opinion on it. I think that stapling Romex neatly everywhere inside of walls and all of it's getting covered up with sheetrock, doesn't matter. When it gets uncovered with sheetrock, somebody's going to look at it and be like, whoa, that electrician, like the last guy that was here, really knew what he was doing. That's outstanding. Or anybody that has to do, you know, like remodel work, they go up in an attic and they see your work and everything looks neat, clean, and well thought out, they're going to be like, oh, okay, this house was wired really well by somebody who gave a shit. It's like the whole idea behind saying nobody's ever going to see it, it's getting covered up by sheetrock. It's kind of like, would you want your mechanic to say that about your vehicle? Like, just kind of fucking throw it together. Nobody's going to give a shit once we close this hood. Fuck it. That's how I feel about that attitude. That's why I don't have that attitude. Not judging anybody that does. Like I said, do whatever the fuck you want to do. Do work as great or as shitty as you care to do. But my philosophy is, no, dude, somebody's always going to see my work. And I'm going to see my work. And I'm not going to feel good about walking away from something that looks like a nightmare. So that's my opinion. Write yours below, as I'm sure you already are. I love you crazy assholes. And I will see you in the next one.